phones are on silent. Quiet on the set. I like saying that.
Well, see, even Tamra's energy.
But you know, she can turn it on, honey.
I know. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to Broadway and the Beatz. I am Ronnie Ohannon, bringing you all the alternative, independent R&B tunes.
And I'm Tamra Lamese, bringing you all the musical theater goodies. So today's episode, we will feature music from the musical Les Miserables and music from R&B artist Baby Rose.
Thank you for tuning in, and don't forget to...
comment, like, and share.
I decided to do totally inappropriate moves for the sound of the thing.
And don't forget to subscribe too. Hit that follow button, hit that subscribe button. Thank you. All right.
Turn on notifications because you want to know as soon as we drop the next episode. Okay, so today's theme is All By Myself.
All By Myself.
Okay, so let's drink.
So, in keeping with today's theme, we had to cook up something called
the suffering bastard,
you know, because I guess when people are all by themselves, sometimes they're suffering. I don't know. It sounded like an interesting drink, so that's what we picked. So for this drink, you will need
bourbon, you will need gin, you will need fresh lime juice, Angostura bitters, I hope I said that right, and 4 ounces of chilled ginger ale. I like ginger beer, so I replaced the ginger ale with ginger beer.
That's good. I'm not a gin person, but that's really good. That tastes delicious.
Yeah, I can taste the gin, which is... too much. So, keeping with the day's theme, we thought it would be fun to ask each other questions of things that...
would we do them by ourselves? Or would we not?
So this is, would you do this by yourself? So it's not really about preference, but would you?
Would you or would you not? Got it.
Okay. So for the first one, would you go out to eat by yourself? So yeah. why wouldn't you go out to eat by yourself?
Because I get lonely.
I've done it before, but rarely. Like, I hate doing it. When I was in my early 20s, you know, out of the house, out of my parents' house or whatever, my mom would be like, just go eat by yourself. I was like, no, I can't. I don't like it. It makes me feel like a loser.
So for me, I think I used to feel that way. I think within the past couple of years, learning more about the type of person I am. I enjoy my time. I'm an ambivert, so I enjoy being around people, but I enjoy my time equally. So sometimes that means going out and treating yourself to something and just doing it right by yourself. I think last year taught me that a lot about myself, that sometimes I need to disconnect and just, you know, get my head together. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, you got about 2 more times to say, I enjoy my alone time. You guys don't understand, I hear this from Ronnie about 40 times a day.
Well, you know, if it's true, it's true.
So would you watch porn by yourself?
Wow.
No, you don't want to watch porn by yourself?
No, it's more fun with someone else.
Yeah, but I would do it. I would.
Oh, I mean, would I? Sure. But it's more fun with someone else. I would prefer not to.
I would totally do it by myself. And I actually think I might prefer to do it by myself. Because then I can watch the kind of porn I want to watch. And I won't be judged by my porn taste. Oh my gosh, please remind me not to let my parents watch this episode.
Okay. The next one. Would you travel abroad, or vacation abroad by yourself?
This is why we go together. together.
Yes, we're the same in that sense. We like to travel with other people. It's much more fun.
I'll be too scared. I'm like, somebody gonna hit me over the head and kiss me and drag me somewhere. They gonna need two people to drag me, but they will drag me nonetheless. I can't do it. Somebody come steal my stuff and I'll be like, I ain't got no phone, no passport.
Oh Lord.
I'll be too scared. I'd be like walking around like, right. I would never leave my hotel room. I'd be too scared. Would you fart with around other people?
I don't prefer to fart around other people, but sometimes it just happens, you know? So, but I would rather, no, step away, enjoy that by yourself. Don't have other people enjoying your farts. But funny story, my grandfather, when I was younger, he would just fart around anybody. Like, we would just be sitting at the dinner table, like, everybody's just talking and laughing and eating, and it would just, and he would just keep going like nothing happened. Like,
oh my gosh,
this is normal. And like, just wouldn't say anything about it. It's just like so crazy to me.
Listen, you know, I'm married and Jeremy and I have been together for over 6 years at this point. And I totally don't care anymore. And I will totally fart whenever I feel like it. But because of that, when you're in mixed company, I kind of forget. Because I'm just used to like letting my body do what it's gonna do. And then so sometimes I'll be like in front of people and I'll just like let one out and be like, oh God.
I forgot. Wait, is that from the gas, the smell of the gas, or from the just trying to cover it up?
Try to cover up the sound.
Gotcha. Okay.
Oh my gosh. Did you guys learn a lot about us?
Right. About us being but no, really, I do prefer, you know, I enjoy my alone time. You know, I always tell my friends and my family and my peoples, I said, honestly, even in a relationship, my ideal relationship is living right next to each other in two different places.
Oh my gosh. You people that say that.
You come on over and visit me and I'll come on over and visit you and we have our own places to go to.
Oh my gosh. After. You don't get on my nerves with that. But listen, I am nobody's judge, jury. Do whatever suits you, whatever brings your heart joy.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Meanwhile, I'll be over here with my husband in the same house. All right. So let's talk about our song picks of the week. Oh, we should totally make like a jingle for that.
Oh, we should. Okay. Oh, it's coming, guys. It's coming.
Welcome. You're welcome. Okay, so I picked Empty Chairs at Empty Tables from the musical Les Miserables. Les Mis for everybody else. For everyone normal, that is. So it's based on the book by Victor Hugo, and it's set in France. And it's like the story of the main character, Jean Valjean. He's a French peasant, and then he has like this road of redemption, and after serving 19 years in jail, it's very dramatic. There's war and all that kind of stuff. So Empty Chairs and Empty Table is during the war portion of the musical. And so the guy is so sad, like he's singing about how all his friends, like the night or two before, we're sitting around these tables having a great time and being with each other. And now after like this battle, they're all dead. Yeah. So now he's like thinking about how he's so alone, you know, there's all these empty chairs at the empty tables because everyone's dead from the war.
Wow.
Hit it.
There's a grief that can't be spoken. There's a pain goes on. Empty chairs at empty tables. Now my friends are dead and gone. Here they talked of revolution. Here it was Here they sang about tomorrow. And tomorrow never came.
Okay, two things. She better play that cello.
Yeah, she chilling. She is chilling.
And I'm so here for his Beyonce fan. So the hair is
like, it gets hot on them stages, okay? Under all of them lights, I would do the same thing.
But no, he has a really, really good voice. I can see whenever I want something very dramatic, I just need to refer back to Les Miserables.
Yes, I mean, it's called, the translation is The Miserable Ones.
Right, yeah. He has a great voice, though.
Oh, Jonathan Antoine. I mean, I just have chills all up and down my body. Mm-hmm. Oh, gosh, he's so good. And then her playing.
It just added to the whole thing.
Yes, because, I mean, you know, I usually choose something from the musical to see the production in the works.
Right.
His rendition is so moving. Mm-hmm. Like, it's so good. I couldn't not share him.
And then she added all the drama to it, even more.
I'm getting chills in my head right now. I'm like, oh, this is so good.
That's the gin.
Oh. Oh, gosh. Okay, Ron, tell me your song.
All right, so my song for this week comes from an up-and-coming artist, pretty much up-and-coming artist named Baby Rose. I think she was born in D.C. and it's spent most of her life in North Carolina. She is a wonderful, wonderful artist. Her voice is like so unique, and I actually have to give a shout out to my friend Dan A for putting me onto her about, I think earlier this year, actually.
Hey, Dan A.
The name of the song that I'll be playing is called All to Myself. It's so funny because Baby Rose's voice is so unique, but such a throwback. Like, she's kind of a combination of like a Billie Holiday, and I'm trying to think who else I can put it with. But her voice is such a throwback, but it's super duper unique. She's worked with, she's actually provided like direct support for Ari Lennox, who I know you guys like. And so she's been, you know, getting to do her thing more and more lately. This song that we'll be listening to today is really reflective of like her voice, you know, the Billie Holiday sound, but also it's called All to Myself. So it's very reminiscent to me in message to like Billie Holiday's In My Solitude, if anybody knows that. In My Solitude, that one. Yeah. Right. You are me. Yeah. So, so we're going to go ahead and play this one, and I hope you like it.
It's 3 a.m. and I'm alone in this apartment. Thinking about my dearly departed heart. You built me up and brought me down. Now, chasing highs to keep my feet off the ground. Guess it's not really worth explaining. It's been over a while and things have changed, but memories still linger around. And I'm drinking now, but I don't wanna say too much. So I guess I'll keep it all to myself. Baby, I've been hurt enough, so I guess I'll keep it all to myself.
Yeah, like it totally reminded me of like recordings from like the 60s, you know, because there was no auto-tune, there wasn't like a bunch of editing done to the music, there wasn't a bunch of like artificial sounds. So every like
I love it.
Yeah, it's so it's definitely a fascinating choice to put all of, like, she's like getting herself in the mood of the song, and you can hear that. Yes, so it's kind of funny because, you know, musical theater, like, you get yourself in the mood off stage and you come. So it's interesting to be like, okay, before I sing this next verse, I'm like,
right.
So it was kind of funny in that way. So we're saying Billie Holiday. I was kind of hearing a little Billie Holiday and Nina Simone, maybe.
Okay. Yeah.
Also a little Tracy Chapman.
Mm-hmm. I can see that. All mixed up. Mm-hmm.
Right? Just like all those three queens. Mm-hmm. Just
yeah.
Seriously, totally unique. She doesn't sound like anyone.
Yeah.
I'm not expecting her to sound like that when, because that's her picture, right?
Yes. It's so funny because the first time I watched her, I feel like it was a live video.
Yeah.
Like it was a video, but so I went to it and I was like, oh, I wonder what she's going to sound like. So the guy's just playing the piano and then she starts singing and I'm like, who the hell is this? Like you would not expect that voice to come out of her.
Right? Like that is not your throat, ma'am.
Right. You're right. Let me sing. Right. Yes. Yeah, yeah, but she's really talented and she's been getting a good amount of attention lately. So we'll see what happens with her.
Yeah, you guys, totally check out Baby Rose. Yes. I know I'm going to. Check out Les Mis. I've checked it out many times.
And what was his name again?
Jonathan Antoine.
Mm-hmm. Okay, check him out too.
You know, he is fabulous.
Yeah.
He said his name and I got chills because he is so good. His instrument is unbelievable.
Yeah.
It's unreal. It's okay. Anyway, I digress. Don't forget to comment, like, share, subscribe, turn on notifications, tell us what you think. Yeah. Let us know if you have any requests, anything that you want us to cover, anything that you're like, I can't believe that they don't talk about this person or this musical. Let us know.
Because like, what are you listening to? What are you guys listening to?
Yes, tell us. What's on your what do they call them?
Playlist.
Thank you.
Honestly, check out our YouTube channel. We do have a playlist of each of ours on there. So
check it
out. You can listen to all of the songs that we feature on here.
Yes. And until next time, I hope you enjoyed your gin and bourbon mixture drink. Don't know if I'll do that again.
It's good to me.
I mean, obviously I didn't hate it because...
Right. Ginger beer. Try it with ginger beer next time.
No, too much. We love you guys. We will see you next time.
The next time. Thanks for joining us. Bye.
Hey.